This is the J-pole antenna. In fact, it is a half wavelength of radiator, and this stub is to match the impedance to your car's cable. If you split it in the dipole element, normally you have here in the middle, you feed it with car's cable and the balloon, and now we feed it at the end, but we have here a high impedance. If we do in green the current distribution, and we do here with this color the voltage distribution, we come to this figure, and the yellow is also the showing the impedance. It's very high here, for example 1k. So we have to match that. If we have a quarter wave stub like this, and you have to take into account the velocity factor, then you have here a 0 ohm, and here in theory in infinitive, but in practice not so high, of course. But you can connect this together, and then you have the J-pole antenna. I simulated this with mana to get the correct dimensions to start with, and if you have this feed line, you can take 300 ohm twin lead, for example, but in this case I wanted to make it myself. So I do two wires and in parallel, and some tape, and you will see it. And somewhere between here and here, the impedance is, for example, 50 ohm. Here, for example. But it is balanced, but in practice everyone connects just this coax cable to it, and that's it. But you can take a balloon if you like, or that you say you connect the center pole here and the shielding there, but why should you make it more complicated than needed? And we make this first this stub, and then we make a resistor here, and then we check if it is in the correct frequency area. So I made this match to a fishing pole with tape, and added the resistor at the end. And first I tried the 1k, and it shows a dip, but not very deep. And then I tried a smaller resistor, and it gave even less deep dip, but with 4k7 I get the dip that I wanted. But in all cases the frequency is too low, so it is too long. I must cut a bit off.
With a 1k resistor, this graph shows, the purple one, that I changed the resistor to half of it, 470 ohm. Then I get the orange one. It shows what the frequency is of resonance, and it is too low. Then I change the resistor to 4K7, and it shows a clear dip. And then I cut about 9 centimeter of it to shift the resonance frequency upwards to 50 MHz, and then this is the result. So I had to cut a lot to get it into resonance. Now connect the long wire that forms the half wave radiator. The indoor reflection of the total area is about this, the red moving one. I'm now moving the rod inside the building. So it looks good. This length is good. And I now try to do it outside.
The J-pole antenna on the fish rod sticking out of the roof. And for those who wanted to see the SWR, this is forward and this is reflected. Almost nothing. For the ones that are interested to build it, I have this new dimensions. So in fact, this is the radiator, half wavelength, and this is just impedance match and 9.5 centimeter from the bottom you connect the coax cable. No radios needed. The wire is about a half square millimeter, and the distance between those two can be seen on the other part of the video. There depends of course on the fishing rod, but in this case it is about 2-2.5 centimeter or so with tape. You can also use another kind of support, for example hang it with a line to a tree, or stick it out of the balcony, then it is horizontal polarized. In this case it is vertical polarized. Enjoy building this antenna. And if you subscribe to my channel, you find likely more interesting antenna stuff.